And we're going to play offense this time around. We're not going to play defense like we unfortunately did in 2020. We're going to have soldiers, poll watchers on the ground who are making sure that there are no irregularities and fraud like we saw in the last election cycle.
I love it. I cannot wait. It's going to be fantastic. And we do have to, you know, restore election integrity.
Soldiers? They're going to have soldiers on the ground, what, like parachuting from military helicopters? Or maybe she was referring to something else. Well, we know based on Donald Trump's previous statements, he's all for having some sort of armed guards at least, or maybe his own sort of military at political events and at, of course, polling places. At his very first presidential debate back in 2020, President Trump encouraged his supporters to monitor Election Day polling places for instances of fraud. Donald Trump, quote, "I'm encouraging my supporters to go to the polls and watch very carefully because that was what has to happen. I'm urging them to do it. There was a big problem in Philadelphia. They went in to watch. They're called poll watchers. Very safe, very nice thing. They were thrown out. They weren't allowed to watch. You know why? Because bad things happen in Philadelphia. Bad things." Trump also went a step further than poll watchers and said he wanted to see the police at polling places. This was during an interview with Sean Hannity. Watch.
Are you going to have poll watchers? Are you going to have an ability to monitor to avoid fraud and cross-check whether or not these are registered voters, whether or not there's been identification to know that it's a real vote from a real American?
We're going to have everything. We're going to have sheriffs, and we're going to have law enforcement, and we're going to have hopefully U.S. attorneys, and we're going to have everybody and attorney generals. But it's very hard. I mean, you have some of these states sending them out like Nevada, where they don't even have to check the signatures, so anybody can sign it.
We're going to have everybody at these polling locations. Well, everything that Donald Trump just said and what Leavitt, his press secretary, said, well, some of that could actually be illegal. CBS News reports, poll watchers are observers who are typically paid workers of a government organization such as state parties, the Republican National Committee, the Democratic National Committee, who observe polling places for potential issues. Every state has different parameters, but watchers usually must be registered to vote in whatever state or county in which they are operating. Now, poll watchers themselves are legal, but they need to be certified and approved to be at their state and local precincts. Again, from CBS News, watchers are not official election personnel who are in any way part of administering an election. They're acting in the capacity of helping to safeguard voting, making sure that everything runs smoothly. A poll watcher, for example, can notify election officials of issues such as long lines or a lack of poll officials at a site. Each state also has different rules and regulations for the number of poll watchers who are allowed into a particular precinct, and also what they are allowed to do. However, the so-called poll watchers referenced by Donald Trump at the first presidential debate were not approved. In fact, no poll watchers from the Trump campaign, the Republican Party, or other Republican campaigns were certified to monitor the city of Philadelphia in 2020. It's also illegal. In all 50 states for civilians to loiter around polling places and intimidate voters. And that intimidation can include having firearms. Now, in terms of armed police and guards, according to the Voter Protection Program, private armed guards can be considered voter intimidation. According to CBS News, federal law prohibits any civil or military federal officer to order troops or armed men to polling places unless they are needed to repel armed enemies of the United States. And there's our answer. They're going to repel democracy. Isn't that what Donald Trump's really trying to do here? Isn't that what his press secretary is suggesting? That if we actually have a free and fair vote, well, that's a threat to Donald Trump. And therefore, he needs to have his armed guards, his own armed militia there to somehow enforce whatever Donald Trump, whatever outcome Donald Trump wants. Well, state and local law enforcement can sometimes be at polling places, but never under orders from the president of the United States or an ex-president, and they must always be subject to several restrictions. And again, also according to the United Democracy Center, states can constitutionally restrict weapons around polling places. 13 states and territories expressly ban weapons at polling places, and those laws have faced no serious constitutional challenge. The Second Amendment allowing restricting of guns, the Second Amendment allows the restriction of guns in sensitive places. So even though Second Amendment supporters like Donald Trump now want to have soldiers, armed soldiers, armed militia show up at polling places. They have no case law supporting that effort. And in fact, in many places, it would be illegal. Was it seems like to me, this is not about somehow keeping polling places safe or secure, or keeping them from being robbed by that lunatic on the street who shows up. This is about voter intimidation, pure and simple.
A lot of mainstream media don't give you honest news. We do. You know why? Because of you. Paid membership on YouTube makes all the difference. Hit the join button below and you become the hero that sustains us.
Yeah, I think you just laid it out quite beautifully, David, that this is illegal. I don't think these guys and gals in the Trump campaign brain trust, if we could even call it that, think that they're going to be able to do this effectively and quote unquote secure, you know, the polls in November. We know that's absurd. And if these folks do show up, police will be called on them and they'll probably be dealt with that way. I think the reason that they're going out and saying this is to just get the idea out there that somehow a result might be compromised. They just want that concept to permeate within, you know, the sort of thinking of right wingers and MAGA supporters. So I don't think these guys actually think they can execute this nonsense of guarding voting stations and polls. But, you know, they do want to get the message out there that this is somehow needed. This is somehow necessary because somehow the result might somehow be compromised by the dirty, nasty, cheating libs because they can't do anything fair and square. They're just gross and anti-American. And so our protectors have to protect us. And, you know, I think that's what they're doing right there.
It does seem like this, I mean, there's sort of a twofold effect, I think, as you've identified. First, there is the, you know, get the message out in advance that we can't trust the outcome of the election because our soldiers will not be allowed to be there. Therefore, the Democrats are going to steal it and there's nothing we can do. That seems to sort of be the first sort of effort to make up excuses for a result that's coming that Donald Trump may not like. The second part, though, is this sort of chilling impact that it actually has on Americans who may be in, you know, cities or people who don't want to actually have to show up and walk past you know, some guy who's wearing a Trump sticker and has an AK-47 strapped to his belt or is holding it. That is intimidating, and they don't want to have to deal with that when they're exercising their rights. So maybe they don't really care so much about Joe Biden, and it's really not worth the trouble, the heartache of having to sort of deal with this experience. So they're just not going to vote at all. And that seems to be perhaps part of the Trump strategy: depress turnout, particularly in Democratic precincts, and try to get people afraid of voting, whether this is fair or not. And it sort of gets back to the efforts we've seen in previous elections where, you know, the mysterious phone calls made to people telling them the wrong polling places or telling them the wrong date to go and vote, all in effort to try to suppress the turnout and the support of the Democrats.
You know, I actually think these voter depression efforts that the right has undertaken basically since 2012. After Obama whooped Mitt Romney's butt in his second campaign, they felt like, all right, we're not going to beat the Dems fair and square. They're going to cook us. We got to find a way to somehow artificially depress the vote. But I think those efforts, you know, these voter suppression efforts in the South and other places have backfired and have actually galvanized voters to come out even stronger, right? You know, churches and other places organize voter buses so that people can get together and go vote together as a community, right? And I think the more that they even talk like this, the more they're going to rile people up to want to come out even more and support each other and stand up in the face of what is obviously feeble intimidation tactics from a group of people who don't actually believe that they could win on the merits.
And what does it say? I mean, we started this particular story about Karoline Leavitt, who is Donald Trump's campaign press secretary for 2024. What does it say that she would go on Kimberly Guilfoyle Show and the both of them would talk about soldiers and use a sort of, look, there's, I suppose there's an argument one could make about saying we want everybody to be safe going into a very difficult environment politically. So we're going to, you know, make efforts to make sure that everybody has a safe way to get in and out and that there's no hanky panky and that everybody can make this a good experience. That's fine to say, but that's very different from saying We're going to have soldiers who are going to show up at the precincts. Yeah, what a great idea. Let's have militia. So, I mean, that is so imprecise and so buffoonish. And as you pointed out, as we've noted, it's against the law. How come a press secretary for Donald Trump and a possible daughter-in-law, the woman who's engaged to Donald Trump Jr., how come they don't know this? Or do they know it?
Well, to me, David, I think what you got to understand is these folks kind of understand their audience, which is a lot of people who masturbate to their gun collection. And so they do think of themselves as quote unquote soldiers in some war of tyranny against the government. So I think it's a matter of them actually knowing their audience more so than them actually having, you know, an organized, regimented group of people who are going to, you know, stand up and protect democracy.
Remarkable stuff, and we will see where this goes. What could possibly go wrong with having soldiers, with having armed men and women show up at a voting place? Yowza.
Hey, thanks for watching that video. We really appreciate it, guys. And we appreciate it if you become members, because that allows us to be independent, honest, progressive, all the things that you don't get from corporate media. And all of that is because of you guys. Hit the join button below and become one of us. Become a Young Turk.